Praise be to Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to Vajanamrutam. Gospel of Matthew chapter 23. We read, Jesus is criticizing Pharisees and scribes very severely. He uses certain terms which we may not even understand. He says, "Woe to you Pharisees and scribes, you are like whitewashed tombs." My dear brothers, what does it mean? What is the meaning of whitewashed tombs? We should know the background of that time. There was no common cemetery that time, and dead bodies were buried in the roadside. We read in the book of Numbers chapter 19:16, a person who touches a dead body becomes unclean. Same with a person who touches a tomb also, he becomes unclean, and unclean man cannot participate in a Passover meal. And the Passover feast, these roads were so crowded. There was a possibility people accidentally may touch in the tombs. Consequently, what will happen? They may be debarred from the most important Passover meal. It was a disaster for them. They had a custom in the month of Adar, that means just before Passover feast, they used to whitewash all the tombs near to the street so that a pilgrim may not touch accidentally in the tomb. So that was the custom. But in the springtime, when the travelers passed by, it seems to be so beautiful, that tombs, because that whitewashing, when the sunrise comes, it was so lovely, so beautiful. And Jesus is saying, Pharisees and scribes were exactly like that. Externally, they are very beautiful, very nice. They observe all kinds of religious custom. They pray like that, very beautiful, handsome people outside. But internally, they kept all kinds of evil things. Just like the tomb, inside there are bones and decayed flesh. Always the foul smell was coming out like that. So Pharisees had been exactly like that. So my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus did not give much importance for the external actions. He needs our heart. Our heart should be pure. And a man's private life and public life should be the same. What he is inside, outside also he should manifest the same. So Jesus doesn't want our big actions, but he needs our heart, a pure heart. My dear brothers and sisters, let us come to the expectation of Jesus. If you are a praying person, that prayer should transform your heart. That should touch your life. So Jesus did not hate a sinner, but he hates sin, hypocrisy. Sometimes we may fall, but he invites us to repentance. So he needs a heart with a real repentance, a holy heart, not our performance. So whatever we are inside, we have to manifest outside. There should not be any double-mindedness, any duplicity, but 100% truthfulness. That's what Jesus wants from us. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us try to lead a holy life according to the vision of Jesus. So that may the good God help you. Let us pray each other, start a holy life. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.